It's really useful to add captions to TikTok, Instagram, and Facebook videos. Captions are an intricate part of videos that are viewed on a mobile because the sound or the audio is likely to be turned off. This is the third in the series about captionator workflow, and it's going to concentrate on the social media aspect of using captionator. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell because there are five more videos in this Captionator series. By definition, short videos for TikTok and Instagram have quick and sharp and punchy messages, so it stands to reason that the captions also need to be short and not include every word of the voiceover. So let's see how to add punchy captions to this vertical social media clip that I recently published. First, turn off any music clips. Use the V to disable. Select the Captionator destination in the share menu. Skip the next window. In the following window though, select the chevron beside advanced. Select text case and use uppercase. Tick both build in and build out and change the color to bright yellow. Click the font and select Hobo Standard or a font in your system. Use 200 as the size for Hobo Standard. Click Generate. Select the Final Cut library you want to add the captions to. The captions are added to the Generated Captions event in the sidebar. Double-click the project inside. In this case, I'm only going to use the title captions and not the closed captions. You'll see how to do that in the Advanced Options tutorial next. I'll now select all the remaining content, and that's including that grey slug at the bottom, by pressing Command plus A. Now copy that, press Command plus C. I'll open the original project that the captions are to be added to, and move the cursor to the beginning of that video, or press the Home button on an extended keyboard, or Fn plus left arrow on the small keyboard. And paste, that's Command plus V. The captions are added directly above the main storyline. And in this case, they're positioned too high. I need to have them at the bottom of the screen so they don't hide too much of the content. I'll select one caption and drag the word to the position that I want. Copy the change, that's Command plus C. Now I need to select all the other captions by highlighting them by dragging over them all. And that will highlight them with a yellow outline. Press Shift plus Command plus V and paste. Now they're all repositioned. Let's play that clip. You may find that some words are too big and they can be adjusted. And I'll resize that in the inspector. The same can be done for spelling mistakes or to change words entirely. And you can add extra effects. Or you can change fonts. And the video can be exported as normal. There are five more videos in this series that will show you workflows on how Captionator will enhance your videos. The first video is the overview. The second is to add captions quickly and automatically. The third will show you short and punchy captions that will be a boom for Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. The fourth will show you how to use captions in longer videos, that's interviews and tutorials, and it'll also show you how to use closed captions. The fifth in the series will show you how to collaborate on a project in Final Cut Pro when Captionator is creating the captions on the original computer and then allow the other editors to be able to edit those captions. And the sixth is about improving your SEO by being able to take the text that Captionator has created and put it into your descriptions on your web page or into your descriptions on a YouTube or social media. And I'd like to point out that none of these videos were sponsored by Captionator, but they did provide an evaluation copy.